Warning, this video has an extremely unpopular opinion for the purpose of entertainment. Hey everyone, welcome to Never Game Alone, and I don't know if this will be the first video, the second video, whatever, doesn't matter. But anyways, try to watch this entire video before getting too salty, or just don't get salty because it's just my opinion, it's fine, it's just my opinion. I am also well aware that this really isn't relevant and hasn't been relevant since 2013. However, back in 2013, I couldn't even fathom the process of creating a video like this, so just bear with me. Origins is the finale zombies map from Call of Duty Black Ops 2, and is regarded as one of the greatest zombies maps of all times. And I have no idea why. To me, Origins is one of those maps I play every once in a while, only to remind myself why I rarely play it. To sum up the main reason why I think it's the worst map, is because there's just too many annoying things that happen in the map that either make it too hard or just not very fun. Now, before you bitch at me and tell me I suck, just hear me out. I'm not really about stroking my own dick, so I'll save the I got to this round on this map or I've completed this Easter egg on this map for another time. But all I'm gonna say is that Call of Duty Zombies is one of the most played games. Like, I know Call of Duty Zombies isn't a game, but the Call of Duty Zombies game mode is something that I have played the most in my life, and I can confidently say that I don't suck at zombies. Now, not everything about Origins is bad. Some of the things about the map are actually really good. For example, I think it's one of the coolest looking maps ever made, and it sets the entire story for Black Ops 3 Zombies. And while some people don't bother with the story, I find it pretty interesting. The map introduced the elemental staffs, and the staffs themselves were awesome, but I'll get into my problem with them later. A ton of guns were introduced that weren't in previous maps, like the SCAR-H, the Scorpion, and the KSG, which were all guns that I actually enjoyed picking up from the box. The Mauser and the MG08 were also some pretty cool new things to get. Digging up things with the shovel. Cool. You get some good stuff from that. You also get some grenades, or some extra zombies from that. PhD Flopper was reintroduced in the Wonder Fizz machines, and besides Grief Mode for Mob of the Dead, it's the only accessible way to gain the perk in the entire game. There were a lot of really cool things this map offered. But the things that made it really extremely uncool outweighed all of the cool. So, let's begin. You know how most zombies maps have one power switch? A reasonable challenge for each map to turn on the power one time to get access to things that require it. You know how many switches there are in Origins? And I wouldn't even say switches. Six. There are six power generators scattered throughout the map. And not only are there six power generators, but in order to activate each power generator, you have to be standing on it and defending it from these ghost zombie things for like a couple seconds, depending on how many people are in the game. The more people stand on it, the faster it goes. This takes time, more time than flipping a switch, you know, the way it should be, and you have to do it six times. But wait, there's more. The ghost zombies can take away power from any of the stations at any time. This means you have to run all the way back to whichever one and defend it before you lose it. And if there's one thing I really don't like about video games, or you know, life in general, it's losing progress. It's like if I'm editing this video, and then all of a sudden, computer monsters start ripping apart my timeline around the 1 minute mark when I'm, you know, I've already edited up to the 5 minute mark. It pisses me off to lose progress. I don't want to have to be maintaining something while trying to deal with the rest of the bullshit that this map has to offer. The only other map that I can think of right now that does a similar thing is Moon, when you have to stop the excavators from breaching the tunnels. But Moon in general is way easier, and there are only three excavators, not six. I'd also like to mention the fact that Pack-a-Punch is only available when all six power generators are running at once. In nearly every Zombies map, there's usually one or two decent looping spots as well as camping spots, but for some reason in Origins, there's neither. The only spot that I can even think to train is the area underneath the Pack-a-Punch machine, and even there it gets really, really tight, and you can get trapped or cornered really easily. So, basically, since there's nowhere to loop and nowhere to camp, you're forced to run around aimlessly throughout the map, and it doesn't help that the entire map is extremely close quarters and even has dead ends in some parts, so you always have to be on edge or in like complete focus mode in order to not get trapped or go the wrong way by accident. Oh yeah, and I forgot to mention the muddy areas that you can ride the tank over. I guess there's a place to train after all. But wait, the only problem is, you can only run at half speed. And, to put the cherry on top of the shit-flavored ice cream double scoop here, there's also parts of the map where you can straight up be stepped on and just die. Sure, the lights warn you before it happens, but why does it have to happen in the first place? Imagine the map without that god-awful mechanic. And yes, I know it's part of upgrading one of the staffs, but you couldn't have thrown that step somewhere else? Ugh, it'd just be one less thing to worry about, you know? Now, while I think the staffs are great weapons, and the idea of having multiple wonder weapons in each map is great, the process to get these staffs is extremely tedious and annoying. And did I forget to mention difficult? Seriously, there's so much to worry about in this map, but now I have to worry about getting the staffs from three separate pieces, and some of it is completely random. For example, in order to get pieces of the ice staff, you have to wait until it's snowing, and then dig with your shovel in the hopes that maybe you'll get the part. And after you get all three parts, you gotta upgrade it too. I wouldn't mind if you had to build it, and then put it in the Pack-a-Punch, but no. You have to follow a very specific guide in order to get the upgraded version. You have a complete mini Easter egg to get something that you should just be able to put in the Pack-a-Punch machine. Let's also factor in everything I mentioned previously, and you have to do this too. Now, the mother of all shitty things to be part of this map is the Panzer. Yes, the Panzer. For some reason, just like everyone regards this map as the best Zombies map ever made, everyone also regards the Panzer from this map as the best boss in Zombies, which I don't personally understand at all. To sum it up shortly, with everything else in the map existing, shoving the Panzer into the mix just makes it way too difficult. This guy literally ruins games. First of all, he comes around round 6 or 7 or 8, and you know how set up you are around that time? Yeah, that's right. You're not. You're not set up at all. You're too worried about activating Generator 4 so you can grab Juggernog before all the other elements of the map find its way to kill you. The Panzer can also instantly kill you when he pulls you fully towards him with his claw, and the flamethrower is also just extremely annoying. The easiest way to kill this guy is with the elemental staffs or the ray gun or the upgraded Mauser, but wait, it's round 6 or 7 or 8, depending on when he comes, and you're not going to be able to get those for quite some time, maybe the ray gun if you're lucky. To compare really quick, the Avogadro from Transit? Piece of cake. The Warden from The Mob of the Dead? Reasonable. Margo's from Shadows of Evil? Pretty challenging, but nothing a good Zombies player can't handle. The Panzer from Origins? For a map as crazy on all fronts, it's just too much. Even the Panzer from Dereisendrog is way more reasonable, mostly because it first spawns in at round 12 when you've set yourself up enough to handle it. Now in all, the things that make me hate this map the most is the fact that the Zombies community regards it as the best map Treyarch has ever put out. Now, there are maps that I find equally as annoying, like Transit and Zetsubou no Shima. However, we can all agree that both of those maps kinda suck. And the logical question to ask after watching this video would be, well, what's my favorite map? And to be honest, I pretty much like every map, from World at War, Black Ops 1, 2, and 3, aside from the ones I've mentioned. But the ones that really stand out to me are Shangri-La and Dereisendrog. I know Shangri-La is one of the less popular ones, but for some reason, every time I play it, I really just have fun, and it gives me a challenge without being too outrageous. It's hard in the fact that it's hard, not in the fact that I have to worry about so many things and that it's tedious to do everything. It's a pretty simple map, it's just a little difficult. Dereisendrog to me is pretty much everything good about Origins, but without any of the bad things. The bows are way more reasonable to get, the Panzer is challenging but not ridiculous, and it's so aesthetically pleasing. There are plenty of looping spots, there are plenty of camping spots, there's one power switch, and to me it's just really fun. I guess that's what it comes down to, just being fun. So, despite nobody probably agreeing with me, if you got through the video I really hope you enjoyed, and I hope you at least acknowledge my points. I also hope that you don't think I hate you for liking Origins, because I don't. You can like whatever you want, but I could also dislike whatever I want. So, let me know what you guys think. Do you agree with me? Do you not agree with me? Did you like the video? Did you not? Anything. Just let me know whatever you think, alright? So, hope you guys enjoyed, and hope to see you in the next video. Peace out, guys. Thanks for watching Never Game Alone.